Good evening. Welcome to this virtual organ recital of organ music for the Easter season. We're really glad you were able to join us on this Sunday evening to hear our wonderful Fisk organ here at St. Chrysostom's in action. And I'm thrilled tonight for the first time in this pandemic to be sharing the organ bench with our director of music, Richard Hoskins. Besides welcoming you to this concert, there are a few things I'd like to make sure that you know about. And the first is to make sure that you're able to access a copy of our program for this evening's concert, which is available in the box directly below this YouTube video. That's the YouTube description. Make sure, if you haven't had the opportunity to do so yet, that you've downloaded this and you're able to follow along. And beyond just knowing the program in order, you'll notice that Mr. Hoskins has very cleverly divided this evening's repertoire into the various elements of the 50 days of Eastertide. You'll notice headings like Eastertide Festivity, Spring, Easter Day, and that's just my half of the concert. I'll let him talk about his half in a moment. But it's a real scenic tour through the various sounds and colors that we use on the organ to evoke the mysteries and the feelings of Easter and Easter time. You just heard the Grand Cœur Dialogue of Eugène Jégou, which is an Easter morning favorite always. It's frequently used with brass antiphonally as well, although we make wonderful use of the brass we have inboard here on the Fisk. We'll move along now to a piece of repertoire that's a bit of a stretch for this particular evening, but not a stretch at all for the season of Easter, much of which occurs during the month of May. But this next piece is a piece by Joseph Jongen called Chant de Mai, Song of May, which brings out beautiful colors in great contrast to the music that you just heard, soft, light, gracious colors that evoke the sounds and colors of spring. Then I'll conclude with another Easter Day favorite, which is Herbert Howell's Sarabande for the Morning of Easter. Another piece that I think does well not to overlook the rigor and at times gloom, but also great uplifting nature, but very intense nature of the days of Holy Week and the Paschal Triduum that precede Easter. Sometimes it's nice not to begin Easter with quite such a bang, but rather a sort of a gracious buildup and crescendo, which is exactly what Howells does in his Sarabande. So once again, thank you for joining us, and I hope you enjoy the rest of tonight's program.
Good evening, dear friends. It's wonderful to have you with us, and a huge bravo and thank you to Tom Colleo for that brilliant playing. Such exciting and beautiful music, and lovely to hear those springtime sounds in the Jongen. We turn to some French music and English music now. I want to talk a bit about Jean-François Dandrieu. He was a famous 18th century French organist, and during the Christmas season especially, the people of Paris went from church to church to hear all the various organists improvise on the Christmas Noels. And it got to be such a huge thing that the services were disrupted and they had to stop doing it because people were rushing about and talking loudly and enjoying these fanciful creations that the organists would improvise. They also improvised and wrote pieces on popular songs and on well-known hymns. So this first set of variations I'm going to play are variations on the great hymn, O Filii et Filiae, which is, O sons and daughters, let us sing. And this is often sung on the second Sunday of Easter. The words in the hymn talk about Jesus appearing to the disciples and to the gathered group as they ate together and prayed together. And the words, O sons and daughters, let us sing, is a wonderful, joyous Alleluia. Dandrieu uses all of the things that he can in this piece to show off the colors of the organ. We hear the two trumpets on the great and on the swell. We hear the oboe, we hear the flutes, we hear the cornets in various combinations and in various styles, all very inventive. It's a very lighthearted second Sunday of Easter. Following that, I'm playing a beautiful short prelude by Charles Stanford, who was born in Ireland but spent his career in England. And he wrote a set of preludes on old Irish hymn tunes. And this hymn tune that he uses in this piece is the tune we sing, the words, The King of Love, My Shepherd Is. Next Sunday, the 25th, is Good Shepherd Sunday. And you'll recognize the tune immediately. It's a very gracious and elegant setting of this beautiful, beautiful text and tune. The final piece I'm going to play is very dramatic. Charles Tournemire was the organist titulaire at Saint Clotilde in Paris, and he gathered around him a really devoted band of disciples who were extremely, as my teacher would say, admireful of his improvisations. They really were struck and impressed by his ingenuity and his mastery of improvisation. And he was given a recording device sometime in the 30s. And you recorded live directly onto a wax cylinder. And you could record 6 minutes, 5 minutes of music. And one evening he sat down and recorded five pieces. The longer pieces were recorded on two cylinders. So in the middle of the pieces, you'll hear a break while they changed the cylinder. I think in this piece, Tournemire really emphasizes the drama and sort of what must have been, I would think, a blaze of drama at the resurrection when Jesus casts off the shroud and the stone in front of the tomb is rolled away. And you'll hear in this piece, it's really almost violent in sections, very dissonant, very exciting. The hymn tune, Victime Paschali Laudes, Christians to the Paschal victims, offer your thankful praises. And it talks of Mary coming to the tomb and the disciples and our joy in the resurrection. Tonight is the 10th of these online concerts. We started back in July with Bastille Day, and here we are, and it's April. We hope very soon that we can actually invite you into the church for concerts. And perhaps that will happen this summer on Bastille Day again. let's hope. We live in hope. This is the last organ concert until July. In June, we have our Carillon Festival, the first three Sundays of June, and please join us in the courtyard to hear our beautiful Gillett and Johnston Carillon, played by Chicago Carillonneurs. There'll be lemonade and cookies for all. Please come, and we will also live stream it on Facebook. So thank you for joining us tonight. It's our great pleasure to bring music to you from this glorious, magnificent organ, our beautiful Fisk. And we wish you all a very happy Eastertide and a very happy spring.